Hello everybody, this is Andrew Cuneo, getting ready to record a Kaladesh Draft for Channel Fireball. And we started. Alright, Gyarapir Orrery. This card is not actually completely useless in draft, but certainly not a card you want to high pick. It's more of it's a sideboard card if you play against like a deck that has a much higher curve than yours and you can empty your hand. So, really, really narrow use, but not completely useless. The best cards in this pack are Aether Meltdown and Essence Extraction. I think pretty clearly. I'm going to go with Essence Extraction because it's a more powerful card. I do kind of like blue better than black in this format. Other than that, none of the commons are like premium commons. The Peafowl is probably the best common, and it's not particularly good. Alright, so there's a rare missing from the pack. There's a Renegade Freighter and an Experimental Aviator. I actually like Experimental Aviator a lot more than a lot of people, but it does not go very well in like a blue-black deck. You want to be a blue-white deck that can flicker it to take advantage of it. I guess I have to pick the Renegade Freighter here. It's a really powerful card. It doesn't really lead to the kind of decks I like to draft, but I think it's the best card in this pack by a fair amount. Just making sure the microphone's working right. Alright, the next pick. So there's no black card that I'm going to take to just stick solid black, like the only card would be Mind Rot. Obviously can't pick that. If I want to go branch out into a second color, I think it's good. One of these white-black cards is really going to be the pick. None of the other cards are anything to be excited about. This is actually a pick I've had a lot. Cambal versus Restoration Gearsmith. And if you haven't played the format much, it might be hard to say, but the Gearsmith is actually just pretty clearly better than Cambal. Cumball is like a better than average 3-drop. The Restoration Gearsmith is really powerful. The reason it's so powerful is just you get like Aviary Mechanic or Acrobatic Maneuver to flicker it. Or if you get like a second Gearsmith, you chain them together. Basically, the way this format works, there's a ton of comes into play abilities and a lot of things that allow you to take advantage of that by redoing them. So this is one of the better ways to go about doing that. Alright, so this is a pretty easy pick. If I didn't already have a white card, I'd be considering the Contraband Kingpin, but given that it's a worse card than the Gearsmith and it would require branching into a third color, I'm not going to go that way. I think I'm going to take one of these white cards, either the Pioneer or the Artisan. I generally like the Artisan better, just a cheaper card. Alright, this is... Wow, there are a lot of blue cards in this pack. None of them are particularly good, but there's 7 blue cards left in the pack. I think Disappearing Act is a perfectly fine card. I'm happy to main deck it. And Minister of Inquiries is actually a pretty good card in like a controlling energy deck. But I'm not going to take either of those. I think it's going to come down to Fragmentize or the Pillar Bug for me here. I definitely regret it if I go through the draft and don't wind up with at least one Fragmentize in my pool. Not that I'm necessarily going to play it. Pillar Bug is like replacement to slightly better than replacement level 3-drop, which I've already got 2 other 3-drops, so I'm not going to take one of those right now. But immediately I see a second Fragmentize. So kind of wish I had one Fragmentize and one Pillar Bug, but I'm going to pick a second Fragmentize. Certainly not going to start 2 Fragmentizes, but there are matchups where I want to board up to 2. Alright, here I've got a choice between Acrobatic Maneuver, the Broker, the Harrier. There's still not really a reason to like deviate from the colors that I'm in. Like Wild Wanderer would be fine if I had to pick it, but there's on-color options. I think I want Acrobatic Maneuver. Works well with the Gearsmith, then okay with the Artisan. Harrier's card I'm happy to play, but I don't need to pick one up. Alright, here, I think I just want the Metal Workers Puzzle, or Metal Spinners Puzzle Knot. They're both sort of similar cards. But I'd rather have something that counts as an artifact in case I get Dund Operatives. It also works with Aviary Mechanic, or Aerial Mechanic, whatever that guy's name is. This pack is kind of a nothing. So hopefully I don't run that guy. But it wouldn't be the end of the world if I did. Lawless Broker, strictly filler, but maybe I'll need it. None of these cards really do anything. I'll take Mind Rot and probably never use it. So this is not a great start. I think probably the best card I've seen this entire pack is the Gearsmith, and I'm on track to play it, so I sort of think I'm in about as good a spot as I could be, but I did not open a good rare, and I didn't really get past anything insane, so it's not a great start. Alright, here I have to choose between Live Fast, which is a card I might play, or Appetite for the Unnatural, which is a card I like, but doesn't really fit with what I've got. I'm going to take the Live Fast. I would be more inclined to take the Appetite for the Unnatural if I didn't have two Fragmentizes. That's Disappearing Act is a really underrated card. Getting it that late is kind of crazy. Alright, what do we got here? Not a lot again. So this guy, when you first look at him, he seems like he might be insane, but in reality, it's pretty hard to get enough energy to take advantage of his ability. He's probably worse than the Thriving Rhino. This is another card, probably worse than the Thriving Rhino. And I don't have any green cards, so I don't have to pick one of those here, and I'm not going to. Hunt the Weak, another kind of decent level green card. So this is a pretty good pack for green, but I don't have any green cards yet. I'm just going to take the Propeller Pioneer. It's kind of a disappointing first pick, but it is a decent quality card. Trusty Companion is maybe an option too. I think I'm going to go with the Pioneer. It's not clear how my deck's going to wind up exactly. Alright, this is another mediocre pack. Czar Barge, solid card. Probably what I'm going to pick. I don't think I'm going to wind up in a deck that I'm going to want Servo Expedition. I'm not a fan of the Inspired Charge deck at all. I think it's a pretty mediocre deck in general, so I'm not going to be looking to do that. You have to back me into a corner to get me to do that. Shrewd Negotiation's a great card, but not something I'm in a position to take advantage of, since I'm not blue and I don't have any Prophetic Prisms. So I'm just going to take the Bizarre Barge. This is really not going great. Welding Sparks is the best card in the pack. I have no mana fixing, and I can also get a 2-drop here, which I'm pretty direly in need of. So I'm going to take it. Kind of got pushed into white-black, and the packs have not broken great. All right. Fabrication Module, good card in an energy deck. I am not an energy deck. So if it's just Dragon Blood in your deck, it's kind of not very good. Thriving Rats would be a solid 2-drop for me. Though I like it even less than Eager Construct. The Hawk would be probably a better 2-drop. It's that or the Self-Assembler. It's kind of late in the game to be trying to get self-assemblers. Just going to go with the Hawk. Hawk's good with the Freighter, and I've got the Bizarre Barge it's also pretty good with. So, let's try the Hawk. Another Servo Expedition. Not going to pick that one either. I like Subtle Strike. I think it's a good card. This is like straight up white-black mediocres. All right, I've got Herald of the Fair, I guess. Best cards in this pack are Thriving Grubs and Thriving Turtle. Nowhere near being able to play either of those. I'll take a second Acrobatic Maneuver. It's a good card with the Gearsmith. I've got some other ways to get value off of it. And a Mechanic. This is great. I needed a 2-drop, and it potentially is going to do stuff with the Gearsmith. And got a couple things that make servos. Alright, I don't really want a second Live Fast. I don't even particularly want the one I have. So I think I'm going to take a Herald of the Fair. Hopefully not play two of those either. It's pretty... Looks like my deck is going to wind up just being 16 average to slightly better than average white-black cards. I'll take Inspired Charge here over nothing, but I'm not in really a spot to play it. I don't need a third Herald of the Fair. I'll take this Night Market Lookout. Not a great card in my deck, but I have two vehicles right now. Maybe I pick up a Sky Skiff and get something going on. Ooh, the Train. The Train is a pretty good sideboard card in some matchups. If you play against somebody who's just fully invested to gumming up the ground with blockers, you can board in the Train and it's good against that strategy. At this point, looks like I'm going to be short on playables, so I think I'm going to be main decking a Fragmentize. Going into the last pack, I'd really like to pick up, like, a Tidy Conclusion, maybe some sort of bomb or, like, good high-end card, like, Gearhawk would be, the Black Gearhawk would obviously be insane, but even, like, a Wistweaver Angel would be nice. Then I want to get some more 2-drops, too, to fill out my curve. This pack is none of those things. Dynavolt Tower requires a really dedicated energy deck to make function, and I don't have that at all. So I'm going to get... There's like some okay creatures for me here. I'm going to... Visionary Augmenter is going to wind up being the best one. I think it's probably just the best one, almost regardless of your deck, if you're ranking the Enthusiast and like these two other 5-drops. It's probably the second best card in the pack behind the Outrider, or... And if you get the right deck for it, Dynavolt Tower's the best card, but I'm not going to be able to get that deck. So I'll take the Augmenter. Alright. Aerial Responder is a good card. Definitely it's improving the quality of my deck. So we'll go ahead and take that. Yeah, not much else there of interest. Okay, well, Revoke Privileges is the best card here, and I wanted a removal spell, so this fits the bill. Yeah. Wow, second Gearsmith. Things are looking up. I think I want the second Gearsmith over the Revoke Privileges. They're both going to be amongst the best cards in my deck, but I think... I've got two Flickers... And I've got a Mechanic, so I'm in really good shape to get advantage off of this guy. So yeah, we're going to go with that. Also, if I'd taken that Rush of Vitality, like, I can't pick it in that pack because the cards are too good, but Rush of Vitality I'd be happy to put in my deck. Alright, this is an interesting pick. I'm going to take one of these 2-drops, I think. Dragster I could play, but I need more 2-drops here for my curve. I think I just want the 9th Bridge Patrol. This card is a lot better than Unruly Mob. Just because the fact that it triggers on flickers makes it a world of difference. Like, I've got 3 flicker effects right now. Thriving Rats is a pretty mediocre 2-drop, so I'm going to be happy to take that one. Alright. Another interesting pick. I think Propeller Pioneer is the better creature between these two, and Bastion Mastodon's firmly in third place. I think I want a second Subtle Strike, though. I don't have many removal spells, and I only have like one subtle strike as a combat trick. Subtle strike, it's impressed me a lot. I'm just gonna go with that. All right, interesting pick. Do I want a third acrobatic maneuver? It'd be okay, but I think the answer to that is kind of no. This guy hits pretty hard. I think I'm gonna be happy to slot him in at the top of my curve. And right now we can cut one of these guys. So cards that I don't really like. This Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot. It's an okay card, but it has no synergy with the rest of my deck. Maybe another. I already have a Spare Herald of the Fair. None of these are cards I'm interested in playing, really. I guess I'll just... Herald of the Fair is the most likely one to do something. Again, no real cards for me. Or anybody, for that matter. I like having one of these in my sideboard, especially when I have the two Gearsmiths. If I play against a deck that's just, you know, really controlling with lots of removal spells, being able to board that in and get back a Gearsmith is going to be pretty powerful. Let's get a rare draft. I'll take a second pressure point. I don't even know that I'm using the first one. But he thought that the basic land was better than both of those cards. Alright, I think I'm going to want to play 16 land in my deck. Cards that I don't really like. Night Market Lookout. I have no vehicles that crew for one. Which kind of makes this guy not so good. Like, he's good if he's crewing a Bazaar Barge or... If he's teaming up to crew the Bazaar Barge, that'd be good. If I had a Skyskiff he was crewing, that'd be nice. Don't have much of that, so he's on the chopping block. I got nothing that counts the number of artifacts I have in play, which is a big knock against this card. I have one mechanic to bounce it, which is... It's really not much going on there. Live Fast is, like... pretty mediocre if I'm not using the energy, and right now the only way I can use energy is Eddie Tailhawk. Not a big payoff there. I do have, so I've got cards I'm going to consider playing are, I'm going to add a Herald of the Fair. I have two Heralds of the Fair I could add even. Also, like Pressure Point, if I need some filler, maybe Pressure Point can fill that role. I think Herald of the Fair is going to be better than Lawless Broker in my deck, both because I think I'm going to play more Plains than Swamps. I'm going to be mostly white cards. Essence Extraction is just going to be awkward. I'm still going to play it, but I think I'm only going to play 7 Swamps. So I think right away I'm going to cut a Lawless Broker for Herald of the Fair. I also have two Acrobatic Maneuvers, which I can maybe do something with Acrobatic Maneuver, Herald of the Fair at instant speed. Yeah, so I'm looking to cut 3 cards here. And I think I'm going to have it. I think I'm going to play Pressure Point. 16 lands with, like, somewhat dicey color requirements. I'll be happy to have a cheap cantrip. And my deck's going to sort of be an aggressive-ish deck. So Pressure Point can maybe help me out there. So I'm going to say goodbye to Night Market Lookout. You need a pretty specific deck for that one. I don't have it. Puzzle Knot, don't need that one. I think Live Fast also, just... This is not the kind of deck for Live Fast. So, if I do this, we've got... never done that before, but alright. So we've got 14 creatures, pretty good curve. Overall creature quality is not insane. Like, I've got the two Gearsmiths, which are really good, an Aerial Responder, which is really good, but other than that, I'm, like, you know, solid common to filler level common. So not super exciting there. Then my spells are okay. All in all, this deck is like maybe a 6 out of 10, like only slightly better than average. Given that I didn't get the first pick any rares. Is that right? Yeah, I don't. Like, I didn't pick the rare out of any of my packs. I mostly picked commons. It's not that surprising my deck didn't wind up great. Alright, so I'm going to play 9-7, I believe. I don't have that much need to get double white. I only have 2 double white cards. And I do have a double black card. Like, playing Essence Extraction off of 6 swamps is really pushing it. So I think that that's what I'm going to do. I'll save this, and I will be back. Alright, got an opponent for round 1. We'll be right back.